AccountEdge Connect now supports the new sales and use tax features that are available in AccountEdge 2020. So to take a look at some of these changes, first we're going to look at contacts. And I'm going to go over to the customer record. And you can see here that for each address that we have, and we have five of them, you have a corresponding sales tax code and a setting for if freight is taxed or not. So if I'm, for example, creating an invoice and I use address number one, it'll use the STE sales tax code. But if I choose a different one like address number two, it will use the MET tax code. So you can have that set. So each of these addresses has a different tax code and a different setting for how to treat freight. Now to use that, we go to sales and we go to create a new sale. And I'll go ahead and choose Acme Sales. We'll pick an item that might be taxable. We'll go down here and I can see that it's using tax code MET for Metropolitan, and that's because it pre-filled in address number two. Now if I change this to say address number one, that will change now to say STE for state sales tax at 4%. Now one of the other things you'll notice here is that there's a new drop-down for state. This is an optional field. And this allows you to use some of the new sales tax by state reports. And it will categorize those reports and organize those sales by state. So what happens is it picks up the state from the address. And you'll notice here that if I choose a different address, like address number two, and that is set up with Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, it plugs in Pennsylvania as the state in this particular field. Now this is an optional field. So if you have customers where you don't have an address, it's not going to find it and it will show up as none. But then you can go ahead and select whatever state you want to associate this sale with. The other thing you'll notice is that if we go and select a different tax code, we now support tax codes that can be 10 digits long. So for example, here I just filled in a tax code that used up all those digits and we can select that on any of the sales. Now those sales taxes and sales tax codes get set up within AccountEdge Pro and they sync to AccountEdge Connect. Okay, so the next thing we want to talk about is use tax. So I'm going to go over to purchases. Basically, what a use tax is that let's say I purchase something and it's normally taxable, but the vendor who sold it to me did not tax me. Technically, I owe sales tax or what is called use tax for that particular purchase. So let's go ahead and I'm going to choose a vendor and I'm going to pick a blade grinder, and I'm going to say this is taxable. I'll put a quantity of one, but I didn't get charged sales tax, so I don't want this amount here being added to the bill because my bill technically was only $12. So what you can do is you can choose this option here, find use tax, which is set up for me at 6.625%, and I select that. You'll notice that it doesn't calculate sales tax, but it's just tracking that behind the scenes so that when I record this sale and I sync it with AccountEdge Pro, if I run a sales tax report in the section which is now available called use tax, you'll see the sale listed there for $12 and the use tax that you owe, which is based on the calculation of 6.62% on the $12 purchase. So those are some of the features that we've added to support and enhance sales and use tax for AccountEdge Pro in AccountEdge Connect, and I hope that's helpful.